What's up, everybody? Welcome to another edition of Jams and Cocktails, the official premiere of the Jams and Cocktails live podcast. My name is Brad Brock. I'll be your host. Thank you so much for tuning in. And yes, it is true. Every Wednesday night at 8 p.m. Eastern, we will be doing Jams and Cocktails. So celebratory balloons and applause. Thank you for tuning in, you guys. I do have a treat for you. Here, I'm going to introduce him in just a few. One of the most beautiful voices on planet Earth, a very good friend, and we have a bunch of really cool stories to share about our time together, on cruise ships, our ships passing in the night. We'll also talk about all the things we got going on around town musically, and we're going to be doing some drinking and playing some games. So I'm also watching the comment feed. So we're here to talk to you, throw some requests. If you there's something that you want to hear, join the conversation. If there's something that we're talking about that you want to jump in on. But otherwise, I think without further ado, I'm going to introduce you guys to Terry Dobson. Not again, not again. All right, you guys, give it up for Terry. Terry, what's up?
Sad. He does some homework.
You know, man, I got to do a little bit of homework to make sure I'm not completely a dunce when I'm bringing people on.
That's awesome. Good job, Brad.
What's up, man?
Glad to be here.
Oh, good. I've been. You were when I first started doing this show. You were definitely on my top 10 list of people I wanted to have immediately.
Top 10.
Mm. I'm not gonna tell you where you fell in that top 10, but you were definitely in the top 10.
Being politically correct.
But I wanted to make sure that I had the show to a point that I was really happy with it and be able to capture your whole beautiful voice and guitar work. So I'm really excited to have you here, man. What's new?
You're too kind. Not a whole lot. Same old, same old. I'm grounded from the cruise ships. So
you and me both. Oh, man. I don't know about you, but I haven't even been outside of my house today. So I have no idea how cold it is out there. But some people were telling me that there was like snow flurries down in South Florida.
It's colder than a witch's titty.
I'm not sure how cold that is, but I'm sure it's pretty cold.
We're not talking politically, are we?
you never know. There's a whole lot of booze over there, so you never know where we might go.
Yeah. All right.
But yeah, man. I guess we'll jump right into it. What you guys are listening to here is actually from the Speds album. Forgive me.
New Latitudes.
I knew it was Latitudes.
That was their one and only. It was fun time.
Yeah, it was. I was 2003, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, man. I was listening to watching some of your live YouTube stuff, and I was like, man, these were real rock and rollers.
We were doing the same thing. We just weren't famous.
You know, sometimes it's better. Like I think our gig is a little bit better because we don't have to worry about all of that. Selling records or selling arena tickets or
yeah, that's crap. We don't need all that stuff.
Don't need it. But yeah, so did the Speds ever get back together and do any jamming?
We did a reunion I believe it was last year, maybe the year before now. Getting old.
No, I think I remember this when you went up there to jam with them.
Yeah, we got the original members together, and it was for my older brother's fundraiser we did, and they raised over $70,000, I believe, and it was everybody came to see the original band get back together, and it was pretty awesome.
So how many members did you go through from the original lineup?
We changed drummers once. We added lead guitar, Ted. He was our sound man, and he discovered one day he changed my guitar string and was like, "Wow, you're a great guitar player. Want to join the band?"
I mean, you know, worse things have happened. What's up, Marsha?
Oh, she join up?
Yeah, I think the comments come up on your screen, but I think they're only there for a second.
Oh, all right. Hi, honey. I'm at work.
Hi, Mom.
This is my pay.
Oh, that's just that's a tip. You know, checks in the mail, man. So do you have any plans to go back and reunite with the guys anytime soon?
When hell freezes over.
Some people are saying because there were snow flurries in Florida today that we might be close to that.
You just never know. We had fun when we did it. Let's put it that way. It was a good time.
That's awesome. That's killer, man. What was I going to say? You know, it's funny. I have a guitar pick that I found in my cabin on the Disney Dream from the Speds. It's a blue guitar pick. I kept it forever because I was like, this is going to be worth something someday. if only for posterity or for sentimental value. But but I have it. And I think I have another one, too. I think I have a blue one and a white one.
Do you have the new glow-in-the-dark ones?
You know what? I do have. I think it is. The white one, I think, is glow in the dark.
That's funny.
Oh, look. So Johnny Brinacombe Pauls is Lucy Brinacombe's husband, and they're watching us from England right now.
Hey, Johnny. We've never met, but I know your wife. She was awesome. Good girl.
Oh yeah, man.
I love all those people from over that side of the world.
No joke. And that just all those people from the Disney, that whole adventure was out of sight, man. And so to get you guys up to speed, Terry and I, we both worked on Disney Cruise Line on the same ship, and we were both the poolside guitar players. And so we didn't
at separate times,
right? So we never worked together, but we would pass each other in the hallways as he was getting off from his contract, and I was getting on for my contract. And I think at that point, like at one point, we were doing just like a week or two at a time, and replacing one another. And lo and behold, I find out that Terry works or lives in Vero Beach, which is 40 minutes away from my house.
So we've been friends ever since.
Ever since. I showed up at one of his shows and I was like, "You remember me?" And he was like, "Oh yeah." But Lucy, one of my best friends on earth,
John, I have some pictures of Lucy. Would you like them? Not bad ones.
Oh, Lucy's over there going, "Oh, the internet's out on the phone." But yeah, thank you guys for tuning in. I hit them up earlier this week. I was like, so it's going to be like 1 a.m. your time, but I'm going to need you to get up out of bed and tune into the show because it's not very often that Terry and I get together and do something like this.
Good on you, mate.
Yeah. Well, yeah, man, speaking of the Disney Dream, any you think you'd ever go back and do a contract with them?
Only if Marsha lets me.
That's fair. Yeah, I
miss it tremendously. You can't imagine. It's like, it was like so awesome. You know, when you're on, think of it, 7 years on a ship, traveling the world, you meet everybody, it's so much fun.
Yeah, man. I think when I quit, it was time.
But
it
you had to work for Hall in America, though, didn't you?
Yeah, I think that's what killed my soul, really. No offense. I love the cruise line. I had a great time. I'd never, ever take it back. But, man, the gig was rough. The clientele was not really in my age group. And so it was really tough to entertain them a lot of times, especially on longer cruises, you know.
I get it. I went from Disney and I settled in with the Royal Caribbean. And they treat you right. It was awesome.
I missed the punch, man. I spent like almost 6 years with Holland America. Like, my only deviation from that was working for Disney. Right. And I had a great time. I would have worked with Disney forever, but it just it didn't pan out.
My favorite people that I met were from Disney. That was the ultimate, because the people were so awesome.
Yeah, and I feel like Disney's was like the crew was so diverse, man. Like they were from everywhere, mm-hmm. you know, and you know like Lucy and John Erb, who's from Philadelphia, and like all these people, you know, that I'm remain friends with today, you know, like
isn't that fun?
Right. Yeah. Solid relationships from people that live, you know, 10,000 miles away. It's crazy.
I always said that I could probably go visit 70 different countries and talk to a friend and say, hey, can I crash on your couch for the weekend? And they'd say, bring it along. And they're everybody same here, you know. That's the kind of people that you meet on those ships.
it's true, you know. As I had mentioned, Jordan and I went to Lucy's wedding, you know, and I mean, it wasn't even a thought. She invited us, and I was like, "Yep, no, we're going. Obviously, we have to go out there." And
so you were closer to Lucy than I was, because I didn't get invited. Thanks, Lucy.
Yeah, really. Why wasn't Terry invited? We could have been he could have been one other person with a North American accent.
They probably viewed me as the creepy old man.
No, maybe, I don't know. No, it's funny, man. Yeah, like Jordan and I were there, man, and we were, you know, we got there a couple of days early to just kind of hang out and do our thing, and it was like really in the south of England, and really not like a vacation destination for Westerners,
but so they like to drink beer.
Oh, and they thought we had the coolest accents on the face of the planet. And I was like, oh, I feel like a rock star now. Oh, that's funny. So Drew just made a comment. I met Drew on a Holland America ship, and we became friends over music. And we've kept in touch all this time. I mean, we're going on 6 or more years now. He says he thinks the dream is currently out of Galveston, Texas, where he lives, lives in Texas. And he said just down the way from him,
it's an awesome ship. Hey, did you ever do the Disney Fantasy?
I never had the opportunity. The Dream was the only one that I did.
The Fantasy is the best ship.
Really?
It is unbelievably beautiful.
It's pretty comparable, right?
They have, you know how the Disney Dream had the adult where we played up in the quiet zone or whatever it was?
The quiet cove. Well,
the Disney Fantasy has a whole section of like a English style pub scene down, and you play in the bar.
No kidding.
It was awesome.
That's awesome. Yeah, because the Dream had that little area of for like adults only, but it was just that one little lounge, and then there was a champagne room. There was a champagne room.
Yeah.
On the Disney ship. So just put that down, put that in your pipe and smoke it, because there was a champagne room on a Disney ship.
Hands down, favorite bar, Disney Dream Crew Bar.
Oh, God, yeah, of course. Which brings me to my next point on the Disney Dream, on my cue cards. See how official I am? Look at these cue cards.
You're good. I'm going to get my ass kicked when I go home, right?
Why is that?
Why don't you have that kind of ambition?
Believe me, it's psychosis sprinkled with ambition. So, you know, I think she's getting the better end of the
stick. Not to mention Brad's about 25 years younger than me.
I don't know. I just look good for my age. But no, so speaking of Crew Bar on the Disney Dream, how could we forget our resident DJ and the Crew Bar, Justin Nelson, who was also each of our roommates on the ship, because we had to shack up with other entertainers on that particular show. The only downfall, I think, to that particular contract was that we had to share a room. But I couldn't think of a better person to share the room with.
We started hanging out. We were like, I'm probably like his favorite uncle. We would hang out. We'd go to the Crew Bar every night. We'd get off the ship. We'd go hang out in the bars in like Bahamas, and we had a lot of fun. I went and visited him in California. He said he's gonna get me a job out. He's working in this beautiful resort out there.
Yeah.
So, hey, if you need a guitar player, hey, come on.
Anyway,
no kid.
He looks. He looks totally different too. He looks so prim and proper, and he looks good. And, you know, he just didn't care on Disney.
I know, man. I always used to, like, to me, like, Justin was like Ashton Kutcher, man. Just Ashton Kutcher, good looking. I was like short, fat. So we would like roll into the crew bar like Arnold Schwarzenegger and Danny DeVito. And, you know, look at just like the twins. Yeah, we are not identical. But we would roll in, and we would just run the room, man. Like, he was the best wingman on earth. And yeah, I mean, he was all of what, 21 back then?
Yeah.
Maybe if that. And so love Justin. I actually just talked to him today. Told him he needed to drop in. But he said he's doing an event because he's a busy guy.
Well, he's got a good job out there. Like, yeah. Like, he's up there.
Yeah,
and he's right down the street from Donald Trump, you know?
No kidding.
Yeah, and it's beautiful.
Yeah, man. That resort he was telling me about is really, really nice. Yeah, he's...
He came out in a suit and stuff, and was like, what the...
Yeah, right. long way from the...
Haircut
the
suit.
Yeah, those short white shorts and the polos that Disney would give you. I just want to give a shout out to Amy and Paula and Louise. Thank you all for tuning in. I appreciate that. You guys feel free to join in the conversation if you have any questions for Terry or about cruise ships or anything like that. We basically know every single thing there is to know about cruise ships, the good, bad, and the ugly.
We can save your life on a cruise ship too.
Yeah.
Probably more than most of them because we've had so many different counselings. At least I have.
Yeah, let me tell you.
You are too. Every time you get on, every time you do a contract, you got to do the safety stuff again. So,
oh my god,
pros.
Every time. No kidding. And I think that was like that was probably a deciding factor of kind of throwing in the towel. One of them was that
thanks to that stupid captain that sunk a ship.
Yeah, you can't sink a cruise ship and then expect expect everything to just be fine on every other cruise ship on Earth. Yeah. You know,
everything changed after that. We went from a really relaxed every other week crew drill to schnout, you gotta now every week.
Yeah,
it's like you miss it, walk the plank.
Completely insane. Yeah, they started teaching on Holland. They started teaching the cast and the musicians how to drive the lifeboats. And I was like, at that point, I was like, no, I think I'm done.
Well, that would be pretty cool.
No.
Get to drive the lifeboat.
Super cool in the trainings. If it ever came down to having to do it, like, come on, you know how the nights go on those ships. I had no business driving anything after those nights.
Did I ever tell you one of my ships I was on, it was a Carnival ship. And you know where my cabin was? It was right the next door outside of the crew bar.
Oh, that's just dangerous, man.
It was awesome.
Oh god, that's
all my ships were favorite for all different reasons.
Yeah, I had one ship where I was actually on the navigation deck on the same hallway as the cruise director, I was right next door to the Catholic priest. and I had to
bless me, Father, if I have sinned. How often? Every night since the cruise started.
it was crazy, man, because this was the biggest cabin I've ever had on a cruise ship. It was huge, nice big bed, huge, like I could fit so many people in there for cabin parties. And you go down the hall and you go out the door and you're right on, like there's a balcony that goes just underneath the bridge. And like, so I would just go out there and like, that was my killer spot, you
know? That sounded like an officer's room.
Yeah, I think it was. I don't know how I got into that, but it was good.
I got a suite on Disney once, twice, actually.
Yeah, I got a couple good cabins on Disney when they didn't have anywhere to put me.
Yeah.
That's fine. My brother just chimed in. He said, I remember a New Year's Eve when you thought you got murdered, or when he thought I got murdered. My brother sailed with me on a New Year's Eve. Which is also my birthday, coincidentally. And I got completely obliterated. And I had some people. He was out partying with some of the entertainers. And I went to my room and with a couple of people. And, like, it was just debauchery. Like, these girls were, like, writing in lipstick all over my mirror. And then I fell into said mirror in my tuxedo shirt. So my tuxedo shirt was covered in red. I took that off and threw it on the floor and changed. And then we went off to the crew bar when my brother came back to change to go to the crew bar. And he just sees red everywhere, all over my clothes. and thought I got completely murdered in the ship. And then my body disappeared or something. I don't know. But yeah, cruise ships were crazy, man. And Justin Nelson was crazy, too.
Apparently, I played in my underwear for a crew party in the hallway one night outside Justin and I's room. I don't quite remember.
That doesn't surprise me at all. At all. Well, hey, man. I know you guys are. Thank you for tuning in. Thank you for listening to our cruise ship stories. We definitely have more, but I know that some of you tune in for some music. So we're going to play a game that I call Song Pong, and we're going to spin the wheel with Terry. Now, Song Pong.
I was getting pretty relaxed here, Brad.
I know. Now I'm going to have to make you work. Savannah Hearn, thank you for liking the stream. Oh, God. Oh, say it. I might have to bring this up. So
Johnny Depp just showed up.
Yeah.
I don't know if he showed up over there, but.
Oh, yeah. You saw that up there. Yeah. Anytime somebody likes or shares, that all pops up. Okay. So Johnny asks me to discuss crawling through the X-ray machine.
Was that you?
It was me. Remember that? Did you sit in a meeting?
I heard the story in a meeting.
So coming out of Nassau, where I got completely obliterated, everybody was getting back on the ship, and they asked me to empty my pockets. I said, I don't have anything in my pockets. And I don't think they heard me because they asked me to do it again. I was like, well, why don't I just get up here and I just go through the whole machine myself and proceeded to climb up. They did not let me through the whole machine. So somebody might have like embellished that story a little bit. But no, I did not go through the entire machine. But yeah, that became, and it's funny because I don't remember doing it. It's all hearsay. I mean, I remember it in like a dream sequence. But I remember having that. I think that was my last night because then we went back and I had a day off and then we got back to port and then you took over for me. And I came back the next time and sat in a meeting, and they told me, oh, some asshole decided to climb through the X-ray machine in Nassau. And I was like, oh, what a dick.
Yeah, we heard about it in a meeting.
Unbelievable. Unbelievable. Adam, thank you for the follow, man. Appreciate it. Good to see you. Johnny Ringo.
Hi, Adam.
Johnny Ringo just joined. He is the proprietor of the Code Rum Company. Which is all the little bottles and stuff. We'll have to get down on some of that, as pirates do. But thanks, Johnny. Thanks for tuning in. All right. Without further ado, we're going to do a game called Song Pong. It's basically beer pong, but if one of us makes it in, we spin the wheel, and on that wheel are songs that we like to play mixed with songs that we just hate performing. So it's going to be a potluck. It's going to be fun. You guys are going to love it. So here we go. I'm going to get a little sorted out here. And are you good on drinks over there, man?
My beer is kind of dry.
Well, we're going to fix that. Yeah, you know, when we run out of beers.
Thank you, sir.
We have to switch over to the liquors.
Hey, wait a minute. We had a rule, and I learned it from, do you remember Rob and Philly from England?
Oh, yes, of course.
All right. I learned it from them. You never drink liquor after beer.
you never what?
Drink liquor after beer.
Ah, yeah. How does the saying go? Beer before liquor, never sicker. Something like that. All right. Since you are my guest on the show, I'm going to let you take the first shot.
No, thanks.
Just a couple things to know about this board because it's crazy. You have to kind of hold it. Hold the shooter down because it's not attached.
All right.
So you just kind of hold it down and then you just launch it off. So I just figured out how to do the camera for the game board. So now you guys can actually see what the hell we're doing.
All right. They can see us too.
Yep. All right. Terry's taking the first shot.
Oh, I hit this glass.
All right.
I'll
give you a redo.
Who packed that parachute?
God, I hope nobody overshot it just a bit. That's all right. Now it's my turn. Yeah, buddy.
You've done this before.
Once or twice. All right, man. So we're going to spin the wheel for Terry. Let's get the wheel up here.
Oh. It's not awesome.
Terry's
he cheated.
Terry's wheel of doom. All right. Are you ready? And we're spinning.
Can you guess which ones I don't like playing?
The ketchup song.
I love this song.
Well, that's good. That's a solid start. All right. I'm going to let Terry get his guitar sorted out. And,
oh, we got to play it now.
Oh, yeah. We got to give these people what they paid for. By the way, you guys, if you haven't already, in the description of the show here is a link to join the Jams and Cocktails live stream show group. That way you'll get all of our updates and everything that's going on, and you'll be able to get directly into the streams when they come live. And there's also a link to support the live streams if you're carrying around some extra change and you want to throw it our way. So we can keep all this stuff going and keep our liquor shelf full. Feel free to do that as well. Otherwise.
Hey, honey, if you enjoy the show, donate.
All right.
I know you made some money selling shoes today.
Chelsea, thanks for liking the stream. Thanks for tuning in. All right, you guys, I'm going to cut the music down here. And we're going to get Terry. Terry's going to perform for you guys the ketchup song.
All right. So there's a little background to this. All right. It's a Canadian song by a guy named Stompin' Tom Connors. I've played this song around the world. Everybody loves it.
Awesome.
It's the dumbest song you'll ever hear.
I'm so excited to hear it now.
So if you know Canadian... the provinces, Prince Edward Island is a province in Canada. It's a little island, and they're famous for making potatoes. And Leamington, Ontario, where I'm from, it's like the tomato capital of, I believe, the world.
No kidding.
That's what we like to say. And that's where Heinz ketchup was. So this here song's about Prince Edward Island potato and a Leamington, Ontario tomato. Feel free to sing along. There was a guy from PEI and they used to call Potato. Met this young Leamington, Ontario tomato. He had eyes for other girls and she was a little mushy. So they said, well, let's get wet, there's no sense being fussy. Big size French fries, how they love potatoes. Dress them up with Heinz ketchup. Ketchup loves tomatoes. Ketchup loves tomatoes. Got a little catch to it, doesn't it?
I like it.
Well, he went down to Windsor Town to buy a ring on Monday. Saturday, they said, okay, we'll cut the cake on Sunday. Sunday came, and what a shame, they had no one to fetch it. Without a cake, they just sat and ate potato chips and ketchup. Bake-sized French fries, how they love potatoes. Dress them up with Heinz ketchup. Ketchup loves tomatoes. Ketchup loves tomatoes. I don't think it has a bridge.
Who needs one?
So this guy from PEI, they used to call Potato. He has two boys, a little girl, two spuds and one tomato. They walk and run around Leamington, and boy, when they get hungry, the ketchup drips all over the chips way down in the ketchup country. Bake-sized French fries, how they love tomatoes. Dress them up with Heinz ketchup. Ketchup loves tomatoes. Ketchup loves tomatoes.
Yes!
Not bad, eh?
Not bad, eh? Oh, and the crowd goes wild. All right, you guys. Terry Dobson.
Thank you very much.
The ketchup song. I've only heard that song before because I've heard you play it before, and now it makes sense. somebody said the bridge is made of French fried potatoes. All right, so I guess I guess
we gotta keep playing.
Yeah, yeah. I guess we gotta keep playing. It's your shot.
All right. I'm not putting my guitar down because I'm not too good at this.
It's all right. Thank goodness. All right, here we go. Best out of two.
Oh, look at that.
It's the Terry Show.
This is bullshit.
I think so. It's rigged. It's rigged. Everything I do is rigged. All right, we're going to spin the wheel again for Terry. We're going to run out of songs for Terry.
He already told me he's using me to get to my son.
Wow, that sounds so weird. Where is Josh? Josh should be tuning in. I should have seen his name come across.
I sent him a message. My son, Josh, is the rock star in town here. So
he's a very busy guy. Before I spin this, let me look at the comments here. So we can catch up. Let's see. Brad Dreams out of Port Canaveral. I thought it was out of Canaveral. Wonder is currently going out of Galveston. Marcia says, awesome, Terry. Sounded great, as usual. And Dustin said, hey, pour me a shot while I'm reading the comments and stuff. I think we're going to have to do that. We might have to get into a shot here in a minute. All right, but we're going to spin Terry's Wheel of Doom in the meantime. Well, that wasn't a very good...
Oh,
all right. You're lucking out, man. These are songs that that Terry prefers to play, by the way, so far.
Well, I don't know about the second song of the night.
You got to warm up those vocals.
We're going to need to do that shot. Yeah.
Will McKinnon, thanks for tuning in, man. I see you.
Hey, wait a minute. Let's switch songs.
Okay.
Because it was on the borderline of that other one.
Okay.
And because we have to do it in Neil Peart's honor, because he passed away last week. And I saw that go by, and that's a rock god we're going to miss.
Yeah, all right.
So let's do that other favorite one.
All right, we'll do the other favorite
one. We can do the other favorite one another time.
By the way, we don't have any real steady standard rules here, so anything kind of goes. Will McKinnon is actually, he is at Costa... Death Day now.
He's my new boss.
Yeah, he just
you
just
know that.
I know he's my new boss too. He just joined the stream. So Will, good to see you, man.
Hey Will, how's it going? I'll be there on time Friday, promised.
We'll see how tonight goes. All right. So what song is this that we're doing here, Terry?
All right. So I actually played this at Costa de Esta last week, Will. And Neil Peart passed away, as we all know. He was the drummer for one of my favorite bands, Rush. So I was very sad when I heard it. So when I was at Costa de Esta last week, I don't think Gloria was there because I played four songs from Rush.
Yeah, man. I was actually at Walking Tree, right up the street from you, playing there when I saw the news. That was sad. Really sad.
Yeah. All right, here we go. This is for Neil and the other band members. Philosophers and blind men, niche must know his part. So new mentality, close to the heart. be closer to the heart, yeah. Whoa. Hey, can you throw in a lead solo here?
No Alex Livingston.
Brad Brock on the lead guitar.
That is a very, very tough song to sing. There's only two people around town that I know of that even like get down on Rush tunes, man. I don't know. You ever heard of a guy named Scott Benj?
Nope.
He's kind of like down in Treasure Coast area, Palm Beach. But yeah, he's another one with that beautiful tenor voice, man. And yeah, he throws down on some of those tunes too. Like, it just blows me away, man. You don't hear a lot of guys around. You hear a lot more guys like me that, like, sing like Cat Stevens or, like, John Prine.
And you do Cat Stevens very well, by the way.
Oh, maybe I should have put one of those on the wheel. Well, if I get one that I hate, I'll switch it out.
Oh, wait a minute. It didn't work.
Oh, so yeah. You get a free shot. Drew says, you don't hear that every day. Closer to the heart. We're never gonna get it.
Hey!
I don't think that counts.
You got me all shaky.
You're just joining us, guys. We're playing Song Pong.
My fingers are all shaky. I just played a hard song. People don't realize how hard that is to play.
Yeah, I just witnessed it.
Oh, I almost got a rebound.
Almost. Only good in horseshoes and hand grenades.
He's such a cheater.
What are the odds that it would go with? There's already a ball in there. So
unbelievable.
You know what? I'll give you another shot here. I don't want to wear your voice out.
Good luck. They've been trying to do that for years. I was on a cruise ship once and I had a comment. You know how you usually get good comments?
Uh-huh.
I had a bad comment once and I know exactly where it came from. Some guy came walking by the coffee shop, plugging his ears, like 5 feet walking in front of me with his wife, and he was like, gave me the sourpuss look, and I was like, what the? I said, go jump off the top of the deck, because you're just a miserable man. You're on vacation. If you don't like me singing, go somewhere else.
Yeah, really.
Brad's playing upstairs.
Yeah, there's 30 other entertainers on the ship.
Ah! Oh! Look at that. There we go.
So that's what I get for giving you.
That's all right.
That's what I get for giving you extra shots here.
I've been giving freebies all my life. It's my turn to get some.
Drew, we're February 13th. You're coming to Florida. Let me know where about you're going to be, man. All right, so I guess it's my turn here.
Don't forget to bring him a Valentine's Day gift.
All right. Yeah, really. It is it's special. All right, let's spin the wheel for me. And then we'll do a shot before I play the song.
All right.
Sound good? Brad's Wheel of Doom is set to spin here. Oh.
Is that that's a negatory, right?
Yeah.
That was gonna be on my list, but you know, I actually like playing Jimmy Buffett songs.
I also like playing Jimmy Buffett songs. There's 10,000 of them that are better than this one. But it's fun. Crowd pleaser. That's why I put it on there.
Yeah.
You throw some backup harmonies for me?
Oh, absolutely.
A little acoustic guitar. Manatee Island. Drew, you're coming to Manatee Island?
Oh, have you ever had manatee? They're really good on the barbecue.
Manatee Island, that's awesome, man. Well, yeah, you got to come and see me, man.
You ever had manatee on the barbecue?
I never have.
It's pretty good. I'm kidding.
Oh, this is good. This is going to be beautiful. I'm really glad I put this one on there.
Oh, beautiful.
Oh, beautiful. All right, you guys, get a margarita going, and we're going to do a shot after this.
Going to need one. Do you do it in the original key?
Key of D.
All right. I'm your accompaniment.
All right, sounds good. Ready? Margaritaville, you guys. Nibbling on sponge cake, watching the sun bake, all of those tourists covered with oil. I'm strumming my sixth string on my front porch swing, smelling the shrimp there beginning to boil. Wasting away again in Margaritaville, searching for my lost shaker of salt.
Shaker salt,
salt,
shaker salt.
Some people claim that there's a woman to blame, but I know it's nobody's fault. I don't know the reason I stayed here all season. Nothing to show but this brand new tattoo. But it's a real beauty, a Mexican cutie. I haven't got it, I haven't a clue.
I got bored one day and made a new verse. You want to hear it?
Yep. Wasting away again in Margarita, searching for my lost shaker of salt.
Shaker salt,
salt,
salt.
Some people blame that there's a woman to blame, but I don't. Could be my fault. Hear that verse.
Don't know the reason stayed her all season. Nothing to show when this brand new tattoo. It's a map of Wisconsin. It's here on my Johnson. How I got here, I haven't a clue. I didn't do that on Disney.
Wasted away again in Margaritaville. They might have liked it.
Searching for my lost shaker of salt. Shake of salt, salt, shake of salt. Some people claim there's a woman to blame, but I know
could be my fault.
Hey. Some people claim that there's a woman to blame, but I don't.
It's all Terry Dobson's fault. Yeah, and the crowd goes wild.
You're gonna need a shot
for sure. So we have some options. As you can see, our fine selection of spirits. I really do recommend that we give that. That number one, if you're in a tequila mood at all,
yeah. You know, I have a frog in my throat. Can you hear it? It's probably from that extreme temperature change last night. Yeah,
no joke, man.
That was crazy.
Surprised we don't have an iguana in our throat. We're right there dropping.
I heard they're good eating too.
I have heard that.
I just heard on the TV tonight.
I love frog legs and stuff like that too. So I probably wouldn't be too far outside of my. My comfort zone in terms of cuisine. Yeah. But all right, let's grab this.
While you're doing that, I'm gonna practice.
That's not fair. You're not allowed to practice. So you guys, we're gonna sip on number one, which is actually Ron White, the comedian, the stand-up comedian. This is his tequila. It's very, very nice. Don't tell Jordan that we're taking sips out of it because this is actually hers.
He's one funny fella. Have you ever seen him?
Oh, my God, yeah. He's hilarious.
I took Marcia to see him last year. He's great.
We love you, Johnny and Lucy. Thank you guys for tuning in. I know it's 2 a.m. over there right now, but you guys are amazing. Thank you so much, you guys. Love you.
That's nothing. 2 a.m.? You guys are young.
I know, right? Jordan says she's watching, so she's watching us drink her tequila here. That's her.
Are you supposed to sip this or shoot it?
You know, I would try sipping it first. You want to pass me your glass?
Oh.
I'm real fancy, man. I hand out glasses in this joint.
Oh, wee. I'm impressed, Brad.
All right.
You're my new hero.
I could give you a list of better heroes, I think.
Incidentally, Marcia wants you to host or make my web presence better.
Oh, yeah? Because
apparently I'm old school.
you're so old school, man.
I am.
All right. Ready? Cheers,
we're
man.
Just sipping it or are you shooting it?
I'm not gonna. I don't think I'm going to shoot it yet. I think I'm going to sip it first. I might shoot it here before
we...
Let
me taste it.
There you go.
Oh, very smooth.
Right? It's really nice. It's, yeah, it drinks.
Good job, Ron. Yeah, really. It drinks. Leave it to somebody like you.
Right. Well, what's crazy is that it drinks like a scotch, like on ice or whatever. And
you don't want to shoot this. You want to sip it.
Right. We could do that. All right. Well, look at the board of rest for a minute here. Moving on. We did mention Josh. A little bit earlier, your son Josh Dobson is the singer of the local pop band East Harbor, which they are pretty well known here on the Treasure Coast. They're awesome. How does it feel raising a rock star?
Scares the hell out of me. Kid's nuts.
It's so funny in that little reel that I played earlier to introduce you on, there was a picture of the three of us, and yeah. Josh looked like he was 10 years old in that photograph.
Do you realize that is when he first started, he first moved here, and he started, I kind of took him under my wing, and he's come this far. If you haven't seen East Harbor, go check him out. They were like, they play at a Grand and Grape New Year's Eve. The place was wall to wall, out into the street. They're the ones with the searchlights going. It was pretty cool.
Yeah,
cool.
That's a great spot. I like Grind and Grave. They play there pretty often, too, yeah.
But we have to find them some sponsors, and we need to get them out of this town because they can go places. They got what it takes.
I agree. Not to say that this town is bad for music, but for the kind of music that they're trying to do and the exposure that they're going to need to propel them.
Yeah, they need to get out in big cities. They need to go
L.A., west, Nashville, New York, somewhere like that. L.A. is probably the best suit for their... their style, but
I agree.
Yeah, that's awesome. Yeah, I was telling Terry, I was like, you know, I had to get you on the show to break the ice so that I could reach out and get Josh and the boys from East Harbor on the show.
Yeah, that's true.
But he's not tuned in.
Hey, Lucy, that's what you guys could do if you want to do put on a big party over there in England. Check out the band East Harbor.
Yeah, really. We'll get them over there.
And Brad and I will automatically be coming because we'll be part of the show.
Yes, I'll be the
I'm the bus driver. I already told him I'm the tour bus driver. So and we have a private pilot that if we go overseas, we'll just get him to fly us over there. And you know,
I'll find something to do.
You're gonna be stage deckhand.
Yeah, I'll be the mixologist. I'll change the strings on the guitar.
Yeah, there you go. He's gonna need somebody like that.
just to let you guys know, we're gonna figure out. Actually, what time is it? Is it
9:00?
9:00, man. I'm right on schedule. It's like built in now. We're gonna do some shameless plugs right at the top of 9. So we'll start with you. I know that you play a couple places. I know for sure you play at Costa. Will, who manages that, was just in there. And that's Gloria Stefan's resort up in Vero Beach. I play there also, but you play there more than I do now.
When do you play there? We used to rotate.
I know. Well, they started doing the Saturdays. They started doing it at nighttime.
Oh.
And I was able to swing with all those alternating Saturdays because I would either do the farmer's market right next door, or I would have something later in the evening. But when they moved to the nighttime, like, I wasn't able to swing it. But I guess they're doing some things during the afternoon.
Josh,
so
Josh is going to DJ there Sunday afternoon.
Have
you ever
kidding.
Seen him DJ?
No.
That's pretty funny.
Yeah, it's good.
He's good. He's like, the kid's like music. If it wasn't for music, he'd be homeless.
Yeah, well, I can't say that I'd be too far behind him.
I'm the same way. What do you call it? What do you call a musician without a girlfriend? Homeless.
Homeless. That's right. That's right. Jordan, don't get any ideas.
I earned my wings, just so you know.
Yeah, that's good. That's good. So where else? I know you play at Costa. You still playing over at Pierce Cider Works at all?
Once a month I play at Pierce Cider. I'm going to play Riverside Cafe Wednesday night.
Nice.
Next Wednesday. Killer. I love that place. Is awesome.
Yeah, I love Riverside.
In season is great.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm opening up for Journey in February, and I'm opening up for Queen in February. Yes.
What?
Yeah.
Where at?
At Summer Crush Winery. Yes, sirree, Bob. And I'm not allowed to sing Queen or Journey. That sucks. But anyway, I'm going to be opening up for Queen and Journey.
That's killer, man. Yeah. Very, very cool.
Talk about a kick in the nuts.
Man, I need to get out to that spot. I have not been out there ever.
It's actually a very cool spot, very cool venue. You're out in the middle of nowhere. It's a beautiful winery. It's just nice.
Yeah,
and he always gets entertainment. Like I'm playing for the tribute Journey. Yeah,
we don't need to talk about that. Just as good as the real thing. I mean, let's be real. What is there? One guy left in Journey that's the original member.
Did you know what's his name? Steve Perry. His birthday is he's like 72, I think. Like that.
Right. It's today, right?
Today is
Steve Perry's birthday. Yeah. He's out there. I mean, he just refuses to get back together with the guys from Journey.
It sucks. If I could talk to him, it's like, dude, your voice isn't going to last all your life. Go do it now.
Right. It's probably because he's stopped doing it that he's able to do anything that he's doing.
Maybe. Yeah.
And he turned into Steven Tyler, who just, you know, love him to death, love what they've done for music. But, man, he has a hard time. Same with David Lee Roth, even. You know, I just saw a video of him recently just butchering his own songs. And that's tough.
Their voices are pretty bad.
Yeah.
You know who my hero is, eh?
Yeah.
He's like a solid rock. He's constantly touring. He's got to be 12 years older than I am. So when I see him on stage, I got 12 more years starting now, at least.
Yeah, it's all that tantric sex that he has with his wife that keeps him young, I think.
Oh, that's right. Forgot about that.
Yeah,
I'm gonna have to work on that.
Good luck, pal. You're on your own.
It's like they have sex for like 7 or 8 hours, something like that.
Oh yeah, it's and then they never reach the end, which is
that'd be awesome. Just,
I mean, sure, whatever floats your boat. But you know, like, I got sandwiches to make. I got places to be. Jordan and Dan, thanks for tuning in, you guys.
The Brad Brock Show just went down low.
Yeah, I got this whole bottle of tequila in front of me.
You know, I spent a lot of time in California, right?
Yeah, recently. Yeah, I saw that. No landslides, no earthquakes?
No, but I'll tell you what. I discovered out there, they have good gummy bears.
Yeah, we're actually going to Vegas in the beginning of March, and they have good gummy bears too.
When are you going in March?
I think like the first weekend in March we're heading out there.
Oh, let us know, because Marsh is going to be out there, and I'm going to be going back and forth, but if we're out at the same time, we'll come visit you.
Oh my God, that would be amazing. Yeah, we're out there the first weekend for Jordan's 30th birthday.
All right.
Oops, did I just time out her age?
Oh, just threw her under the bus. Yeah, she's really old.
Drew says Keith Richards drinks tequila, so we're on the right track.
I think I'm starting to get up in the age where I'm defying all the rules.
Yeah,
I feel great.
Yeah, I'm happy for you. I feel like taking a nap almost all the time.
I contribute it to the gummies. I don't drink near as much as I used to.
Yeah, you know, I have heard that that like cannabis and THC, or not THC, that's the good stuff.
I swear by it.
Gosh, just
won't be able to do any more cruise ships for a while.
yeah, we're working construction or anything like that.
Actually, that's BS anyway, because all that's going out the window, because they're starting to realize that, ooh, maybe we are wrong on this one.
Yeah, you can't eat some gummy bears, but you can drink. Yeah, the liquor.
Throw up all over the stairwells for the fire escape.
Oh my God!
Or piss on the fire door. I saw somebody do that once. They escorted them off the ship the next day.
Yeah, I imagine they would.
I was like, "What the hell are you doing?"
That's terrifying.
Right in the crew bar fire door.
Oh man! All right, you guys. Well, it's 9 o'clock, so I'm gonna run through some shameless plugs. If you bear with me, we'll get back to some music and some games here. Just want to let you guys know where I'm gonna be over the next few days. Here, you can find me. Yeah, go for it, man.
All right, this is a good time for that. I'm going to tinkle.
You can find me and Justin Mandel at the Square Grouper Tiki Bar in Fort Pierce for Fort Pierce Thursdays. We'll be there at 8 o'clock tomorrow night. Also, I'll be at Hurricane's Wing and Grill in Palm City the following afternoon. Or, I'm sorry, not the following, but that's Saturday. And then Square Grouper in Jupiter on Monday. And then, of course, Captain Hiram's on Tuesday coming up with Justin. Also, just to let you know that you can find out everywhere that I'm playing at bradbrock.com, or you can get the Brad Brock mobile app from iTunes or the Google App Store, Google Play App Store. It's totally free, and you can watch these streams in there. You can request songs at my shows through there. You can see everywhere I'm playing, get news and updates and all kinds of fun stuff actually coming to the app pretty soon. So that's the Brad Brock Music app for your smartphone. Just to let you know, some friends are having open mics out there on Wednesdays. So if you're tired of listening to me and you want to go out and jam yourself, there's open mic at the Deck in Stewart at 6 p.m. And that is hosted by my friend Jeff Farishidian from Treasure Coast Entertainment. And then, of course, on Wednesday at 8 o'clock at Hop Life Brewing in Port St. Lucie, you have open mic going on with Zach from Snorkel Corn Entertainment. So two great places to go and show your stuff. Just to let you know, next week on the show, we have singer-songwriter Andrew Scott, who is another dear friend and very, very awesome artist here on the Treasure Coast. I'm sure you've seen him around town. So make sure that you put it on your schedule to pop in next week at 8 o'clock on Wednesday to hang out with me and Andrew. Be sure to like and share if you are enjoying this. Like and share this stream. And subscribe to Brad Brock Music's YouTube channel. And you can watch this podcast back in HD. HD. Just a couple more things, you guys. Please join the Jams and Cocktails live stream show group on Facebook. The link is in the description here on the video. So check that out. And, of course, Jams and Cocktail is now streaming every Wednesday night at 8 p.m. And I'll be featuring local musicians like Terry. And other special guests. And, of course, if you enjoy the show, please like, comment, and share. And you can take it a step further and donate to our cause, which is to make sure that the bar is stocked and all our equipment is up and running and we can keep evolving and advancing in this cool podcast streaming world because, after all, I am a broke musician. And I appreciate you guys tuning in. With that being said... We are moving on. Right, Terry?
Yeah. Hey, I'm sitting over here watching you, and I'm having a vision. You have something like, you know, Howard Stern. You could do like a Howard Stern thing. You got something he doesn't. You know how to play guitar. You're a talented musician. True. And you got the couch here. We can do it all.
We could do it all.
You get it going.
All right.
Take him out of business.
Well, you know, radio's going out just like radio did in the 80s. It's all happening again, you know. Yeah, video true. Killed the radio star, and now the internet's killing the radio star again.
That's true.
Oh, man. All right. Well, you guys, I see you all in there. Let's play some more music. What do you say, Terry?
All right.
All right, is it my turn? I think it is, because I lost, right?
Yep.
All right, here we go. Song Pong.
Oh, that means you have to play your own bad song.
Definitely not. I don't think that's fair.
Or you have to do a shot.
I got too many balls. I also don't think we're playing right because we're not taking any of the cups out that we're making them in.
That's okay.
That would take forever if you did that.
I know, right? We're having a hard enough time getting them in all of them. All right, here we go. For real this time.
3, 2, 1. Ooh. That was a
miss. I suck again.
That was a miss.
I have to find a little, some more jams here. Some better jams.
Come on, Terry.
Come on, Terry.
Oh, right.
You got it.
In the front.
Thank you very much. How about that? How about that? All right. So that's me, huh?
That's you.
All right. D and Danny, thanks for our Donnie. I remember how to pronounce your name, Donnie. All the way from Canada. Canadian
fellow,
brethren.
Fellow Canadian. Eh?
Yeah. Where's my wheel at? Here we go. All right. I forget how to run all this stuff. All right. Here we go. Spinning the wheel of doom. Oh, Southern Cross. All right. Oh, you could throw some harmonies on this. I know you know this one.
All right. Let's suit up here.
This is one of, by the way, this is one of my favorite songs.
Is it?
Yeah.
I saw these guys for their Daylight Again tour. when this came out.
Oh yeah?
It was unbelievable. I was in Michigan, and the band opened up for him.
Oh, what a... It was freaking the band awesome. Opened for them.
Yeah, it was unbelievable. And it was in Pine Knob, and you're sitting on this lawn, and it's so beautiful.
Jordan says, have you ever heard the term holy-a what? Or is that just a Northern Michigan thing?
Holy-a what?
Holy-a what?
Never heard of holy-a what.
She's cracking up in there.
Pine Knob, there you go, Jordan Taylor. Pine Knob. What's that mean? I don't understand. No comprendo.
I don't know what anything means that she
Pine,
says.
Well, Pine Knob is where I saw Crosby, Stills, and Nash with when the band opened up for him. I didn't understand the DTE. That you're, yes, it is. I saw somebody there too.
Oh my gosh, she knows everything.
I lived in Troy, Michigan, which was
that's right,
for 4 years.
Oh my God, that's where Jordan grew up.
Well, we were right down the street, and we would go. Any given night, like let's go do something. We'd drive up to DTE. We'd go pay for the parking. We'd walk up. People put lawn seat tickets on the garbage pails because they got upgraded their seats and they sit them on lunch. I've seen so many bands for free at Pine.
Just because you pick up those tickets off
you
of the can.
Pick up the lawn tickets. Yep. And then you get up there and you just sneak as far up as you can get.
That's so great.
It's awesome.
That's so great. Oh man.
the things you used to do to see musicians. But no, it was great. It was a great time. Yeah.
Now I'm a sissy on this song. I play it in G.
I don't know. What the hell?
Come on, man. It's only an A in regular life.
That's what the singer of Foreigner. Singer of Foreigner. They drop all their songs. Two S, like a whole step.
Oh my God!
I was like, I can be the lead singer for one or two.
So I do it in G. It's just G.
Brad,
F, C.
Come on.
So that's the life we're living.
All right. I'm messing with Brad now. Sorry, Brad. Shouldn't mess with the host.
It's like somebody's got to. It's the most action I'm getting today. Got out of town on a moon for the southern islands. Sailing in a reach for a following sea. She was making for the trees on the outside. In the downwind run to poverty. And off the wind on this heading lies the Marquesas. Got 8 feet up one line. Nice and bacon way in a noisy bar at Avalon. I tried to call you. Call me now once I realize why I tried. She ran away. Think about how many times I have fallen. Spirits are using me. Larger buses calling. Whatever brought you and me cannot be forgotten. I have been around the world looking for that woman, girl, who knows love can endure. And you know it will. You know. Now when you've seen the Southern Cross for the first time, you understand now why I came this way. Cause the truth that you've been running from was so small. It's as big as a promise, the promise of a coming day. So I'm
sailing for tomorrow. My dreams are dying, and my love is an anchor tied to you, tied with a silver chain. I have my ship and all my prayers are flying. She's all that I have left, and music is her name. Think about how many times I have fallen. Spirits are using me, but your voice is calling. Whatever brought you and me cannot be forgotten. I have been around the world looking for that woman, girl. No, she knows love can endure.
Take a little ride. Now we cheated, and we lied, and we're testing. And we never failed to fail. It was the easiest thing to do. You will survive, be invested. Someone strong comes along and makes me forget about loving you. Let us up the cross.
When I screw it up next time I play it, I'm going to blame you. That was good, Brad.
Yeah, no. Yeah, I don't play it like the record. Not even close. But it's awesome. Mine's like a hybrid of the Jimmy Buffett version and then some abomination that I do. Ah, there was something I want to talk to you about. And I can't remember now.
Well, let's do another shot.
Sounds good to me.
Oh, I remember.
I remember what it was. Do you remember Sound of Silence?
Ooh. I'd have to follow you.
Well, I'd have to follow you.
I was thinking that over on the way over here. I said, we used to play those songs together.
Yeah, we had some pretty good
we had big cruise plans.
Yeah, it's so funny, man. Like I was completely on board with all of it,
and then we met girls.
You met a girl, and I got so busy like playing music around town, man. Like it just, when it rained it poured, like all of a sudden out of nowhere it was like pow. Hey, like man, you. We were working.
Nope.
But it's good. Not complaining. How you looking over there on that brewski? Ready?
It's a little dry.
Ready for another? Pass the Senate on my way. Oh. All right.
What a host. Marsha, you're going to have to come pick me up.
He said I can spend the night here.
They got a couch in the office, so.
Yeah, totally. We totally do.
We'll see what the next hour brings.
All right. How you guys doing out there? What is everybody out there drinking tonight? All of you guys tuning in here. I appreciate you all taking time out of your day. Remember that every Wednesday night, Jams and Cocktails is going to be happening at 8 o'clock. So it's going to be a regular thing. And we're going to have, we'll definitely have Terry back. Marsha says, Terry, behave.
I can't come next week, sorry. I'll be playing at the Riverside Cafe in Vero Beach, Florida.
Yeah, what
3,
time 2, is 9, that?
6,
what
3.
Time?
Hmm?
3 o'clock?
No, 5:30 till 8.
5 to 8.
5:30 till 8. Yeah.
If you get there at 5, you won't see him.
It's pretty good. It's pretty good gig.
Yeah, not too shabby.
I like it a lot. Dave and Alan, they're awesome.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. So you guys, next Wednesday, be sure to go out and see Terry from 5:30 to 8, and then immediately tune in to Jams and Cocktails at 8 o'clock.
I don't know about you, but my friends never come out to see me anymore because they're like, yeah, we've known Terry for, 30 years? We've seen him lots of times. We come out on Christmas and holidays now.
Yeah, you know.
Think of me like your church.
I'm not going to lie. One of the major reasons that I kind of started doing the show was because I find that, you know, like as a local artist out there playing all the time. Jordan says she likes when you do Roxanne. We might have to skip over to that one. Let you do that.
Do I know Jordan?
Yeah, Jordan's in his house.
That Jordan. Yeah. I thought you were talking about somebody from England.
No, but I was saying, you know, as entertainers, man, we play a lot of the same places. We play a lot, you know, to earn a living. And, you know, yeah, it's hard to, you know, especially when our friends and our family and our fans know that we're going to be somewhere every night of the week. You know, it's tough to get them out to every show, you know. So this is kind of a way to switch it up, you know.
That's awesome.
Yeah,
I like the way you think.
But I'm gonna take Jordan's comment as a request, and I think you're gonna have to do Roxanne.
All right.
Yep.
All right. This good call. You wait any longer, I'm not gonna be able to play it. This next song's for Jordan.
And I'm gonna use this as my pee break.
Ooh, don't leave me with all your stuff here. Jordan, you don't have to put on the red lights. Those days are over. You don't have to wear that dress tonight. Walk the streets of money. You don't care if it's wrong or if it's right. Roxanne, you don't have to put on the red lights. Roxanne, you don't have to put on the red lights. You don't have to put on the red lights. Put on the red lights. Roxanne, I loved you since I knew you. I wouldn't talk down to you. I have to tell you just how I feel. I won't share you with another boy. I know my mind is made up, so put away your makeup. I told you once, I won't tell you again, it's a bad way. Roxanne, you don't have to put on the red lights. Roxanne, you don't have to put on the red lights. You don't.
Yeah.
Thank you very much.
Yeah.
The crowd goes wild.
Oh, thanks for that request, Cher. Cheers. Or Jordan.
That's for Jordan.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, that's a great song. That's probably one of the first songs I ever heard you play.
That's the one that made that guy's ears go numb on a celebrity cruise I was on. He was walking by and he was going, he gave me the, oh, that was the bad comment I met. I was playing Roxanne. And he said, he sounds like someone screeching. Oh, it hurt my ears.
I know. It's really tough to, that was another thing about that gig, man. It's like there was, you know, like you'd have one cruise, man, where you just owned your lounge and like people would just flock every single time to come and watch you play. And then the very, you know, and you're just super high on live music. And then the next cruise, everybody hates your guts. And it's like, what's happening? But it's so true. You know, like I have guys like Drew, who was just, you know, totally a music lover on the cruise. And, you know, and we became lifelong friends now because of it. And then you'd have people that just, you know, write the literal worst things possible on earth about you. And it's like, come on, man. Yeah. If I ruined your vacation because you didn't like the songs I played or my voice or whatever, like, that's, you need to figure out something else. Maybe you should have stayed home.
I got called into, what was the cruise director's name on Disney Dream?
Was it Ray?
No.
Was it a woman at the time?
No, big black guy.
I don't know. I don't remember him.
He was a great guy. he's on the fantasy, and he loved me. He didn't like me on the dream, but he liked me on the fantasy. And the reason he didn't like me on the dream because we got a bad comment. And he calls me into his office one day. And he goes, Terry, he says, we got quite a few people that really like your music, but this one comment kind of puzzles me. he says, the singer is aggressive. He has aggressive compulsive or something like that.
What?
And I looked at him. I laughed. I said, "What the hell?"
What is aggressive compulsive?
I know exactly what it was. It was when that school shooting went down, and you know that song, all the little kids with the pumped up kicks.
Oh yeah.
I used to play that, and a lady, must have been a liberal, she took offense to it. Mm. And I got this big write-up, and I got called into the office in Disney because of that liberal lady. She did not like me singing that song. It was
because of a song.
And unbelievable. I was like, are you kidding me? I said all the kids love the song. It's like the huge, one it's of the biggest
40.
Songs.
It's top 40 on the radio, especially during that time.
Yeah, she took offense to it, and I got called into the office for it.
Incredible.
Bitch.
What are you going to do? You know, it's actually funny that you bring up that song, because I was just going to ask you, if you had a single album in your collection or that you listen to that kind of takes you back to like,
I know
like
where this is going.
Yeah, you like listen to it and it like transports you to like another place or time.
Absolutely.
You know? All right.
Hands down, Boston's first album.
Which one was their first?
I think it was called Boston.
No. Oh. Was that the one with the spaceship?
Yeah, like. Freaking yes. Awesome. I could listen to that music
so
all
good.
Day, every day, 24/7 to this day.
Yep. Yep. That's.
Yeah, I love it.
I bring it up because. It was one of the.
Playing song, a little bit rock and roll. Yes. I love it.
That's one of the first, like, rock and roll albums I ever listened to. And at the time, I could probably listen to it, put it in now, and know every song like as it's coming up. You know, there's several records that I have that are.
What are yours?
Like that. Well, it's funny that you bring up Pumped Up Kicks by Foster the People.
That was your favorite band growing up?
no. But their album Torches came out right around Disney Dreamtime where I met you.
Is that the one with the song on it?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's Torches. Why I played it.
Yeah. I literally listened to this record nonstop, on repeat, like tons of times. When I got finished with my Disney record, with my Disney contract, I went over to England for vacation and hung out with Lucy and a couple other friends from cruise ships.
Lucy in the sky with diamonds.
And... But the whole time, like, I had my BlackBerry at the time, and that was popular back then. And was on the tubes, you know, going from place to place. Man, I was listening to Torches, man, and it was just every time I hear songs off of that record, it just shoots me right back to those to the subways in London. And it's crazy, man, how music can take you right back to a spot. And that's why I wanted to ask you if you had any songs or any records that you could listen to that just bring you right back to a moment, you know?
Oh, many. Yeah, there's lots. Remember Sailing? The song Sailing?
Oh, yeah.
Christopher Cross?
Yeah,
Christopher Cross. I was 16 years old. My best friend growing up was from Michigan. He was exactly a year older than I was. Mm. And his sister used to buy us beer. We were underage, of course.
Sure, sure.
So we crossed Lake Erie in a 14-foot sailboat. Him and I, we had two 24 packs of Canadian beer, one Molson Canadian, and a 24 pack of Labatt's Blue, and we had a shitload of combos, and we were literally lived on that for like over a week. We went from we went Pelee Island, we went over to Put-in Bay where our band used to play. Growing up all our lives.
Oh my God.
We went to Cedar Point. Remember Cedar Point?
Yeah.
Yeah, we went there and we hung out with these waitresses and we met these girls at this restaurant we hung out in. So yeah, we just sleep on the sailboat. We brought some Canadian beer and they said, hey, do you guys need to get in the park? We know how to get you in the park. And they snuck us to the back of Cedar Point, jumped over this little white picket fence and we're in.
Oh my God. Amazing.
We had fun times.
14-foot sailboat.
Yeah, 14-foot, no motor.
So you guys sailed the whole time?
The whole time.
Wow.
Yep. We got no wind one time in the middle of Lake Erie, and it's like, oh, what are we here now? Drink beer, eat compost.
wait for the wind to pick up. Unbelievable. Oh, man. Patty wants to hear some Beach Boys. You know any Beach Boys songs?
Yep.
Perfect.
You got to play with me.
All right. All right, there we go. Hang on. What song are we doing? It's for you, Patty.
Barbara Ann and G. This is for Patty.
Barbara Ann and G.
Ba 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 Barbara Ann.
Ba 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 Barbara Ann.
Barbara Ann. We only have two harmonies.
That's it.
You got me rocking and a rolling, rocking and a rolling, bomberin', bom 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 bomberin', bom 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 bomberin', bom 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 bomberin'. Take my hand, bomberin'. You got me rocking and a rolling, rocking and a rolling, bomberin', bom 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 bomberin'. Went to a dance, looking for romance, saw Barbara Ann, so I got into her pants, Barbara Ann. Barbara Ann. You got me rocking and rolling, rocking in a rhythm, Barbara Ann, Barbara Ann, Barbara Ann. Tried Betty Sue, tried Mary Lou, tried Betty Sue, but she wouldn't screw Barbara Ann. Barbara Ann. Rockin' and rollin', rockin' and rollin', rockin' and rollin', rockin' and rollin', bop 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 bop.
Barbara Ann.
Barbara Ann.
Yeah, that was for Patty. Little Beach Boys. Never hurt nobody. Drew says my wife Terry goes nuts over that LP by Boston.
His wife Terry?
Yeah, his wife Terry. Terry and Terry. She's got an I at the end of her name, though.
Oh, that's how it's supposed to be when you're a girl.
Yes.
Name Terry.
So they say.
The girls that spell their name T-E-R-R-Y are questionable. And the guys that spell their name T-E-R-I are questionable.
Yeah, you ever been down to Key West?
Questionable.
Yeah, that's where I met Lola.
Lola?
Yeah.
Oh, look, it was simultaneous. It was like we were on the same brain wave.
Well, I met her at a club down in Old Soho. We drink champagne, it tastes like Coca-Cola. See, oh, well, it's cool. She walked up to me and she asked me to dance. And I asked her name and her dark brown voice. She said, Lola. Hello, well, ain't Lola. La, 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 Lola.
Oh, yeah, you're right.
I'm not the world's most passionate guy. When I looked in her eyes, I almost fell for my Lola. La, 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 Lola. Well, I'm not dumb, but I can't understand why she walked like a woman and talked like a man. Oh, my Lola. La, 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 Lola. La, 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 Lola. Well, we drank champagne and danced all night under electric candlelight.
She picked me up and set me on a knee.
Said, yeah, boy, won't you come home with me? Well, I'm not the world's most passionate guy. Well, when I looked in her eyes, well, I almost fell for my Lola. La, 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 Lola. La, 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 Lola. I pushed her away. I walked to the door. I fell to the floor. I got down on my knees. And I looked her, she and me. That's the way that I wanted to stay. And I always wanted to be that way for my Lola. La, 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 Lola. Girls will be boys and boys will be girls. It's a mixed up world, a shook up world. Say my Lola. La, 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 Lola. Well, I left home just a week before, and I never ever kissed a woman before. But Lola smiled and took me by the hand. Said, dear boy, I'm gonna make you a man. Well, I'm not the world's most masculine man, but I know what I am, and I'm glad I'm a man, and so is Lola. La, 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 Lola. La, 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 Lola. Lola. La, 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 Lola. La, 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 Lola. Lola. La, 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 Lola. La, 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 Lola.
Yeah.
Lola.
And the crowd goes wild.
Of course they do. Yeah. That's a good song. That's one of my favorites.
That's a great song.
I forgot to put that one on the list. Oh, Jack Kern. I'm going to do a shameless plug for Jack Kern. So, that's how we fix that.
You play a Fender?
Yeah, can't you hear it? So, Jack Kern is Jordan's father. And
Hi, Jack.
In college, he was a football player. And he actually played for the Jordan. What team did he play for, man? It was a Michigan college team.
Wolverines.
I don't think it was
Detroit
Wolverines.
Tigers.
No.
The Lions.
No, it was a college team.
Oh,
she'll chime in a minute. Anyway, so he played. He actually played on a team with Steve Mariucci, who's a renowned football coach, and. The Wildcats. Wildcats did growl.
All right.
As Jimi Hendrix says. All right. The Northern Michigan University Wildcats. So The story is, it's a Cinderella story. They went an entire season, an entire losing season, completely shut out. And then the very next season, they came back, won every game and the championship. And so they put together a documentary called Put Your Hands on the Line. And it kind of goes over this whole story. And Steve Mariucci is commentating, and like they're interviewing the coaches and the old teammates. So he is a producer of this, and now they're like going and being shown at a film festival in Michigan. So Northern Michigan U, yep. And so they're going up there, I think this weekend, or maybe the first weekend of February.
You ever been up there?
I have only been to Detroit one time.
Oh my God, Northern Michigan is beautiful. I used to go snowmobiling up there every year with my friends. Oh, beautiful.
Yeah, we're looking to go in the summertime. I heard that it's better in the summer.
Well, it's good all year long. You can get the cherries one time. You get everything. They do everything up there all year long. And you go to Mackinac Island. There's this island. They don't allow any cars up there. And you'll see bicycles, people walking.
Oh, I've heard about this. Jordan has told me about this.
Yeah, it's amazing. It's awesome. Yeah, Northern Michigan's awesome.
Yeah, we're going. Her grandparents live in Escanaba. So we're probably going to go visit them this summer sometime, which will be my first time up in the UP. Very excited.
You're going to love it.
Yeah, I've never been.
Do you like fishing?
I love all kinds of stuff, man.
And so. They have all these fish stands. You get fresh smoked fish.
Oh, awesome. Yeah. Awesome.
And lots of cobbler and pies and yummy.
Jordan says Terry knows what's up. He knows all the stuff.
I've been all around this great big world, and I've seen all kinds of girls.
Woo.
There's some that's the Beach Boys.
There's some more Beach Boys for you. Or David Lee Roth, depending on your mood.
I love the David Lee Roth version of that.
It's so good.
That is the best.
Actually, I think it's that video that I saw of him performing in Vegas where I was just like, oh, Dave.
Sit down, Waldo.
Oh, man. All right, where are we at here? All right, so we got about 15 minutes left here. You want to... Want to do another little shot of something?
All right.
Are you a cinnamon fan at all?
Oh, Fireball.
Yeah, you like Fireball?
I do.
I do, but my friend Johnny Ringo, the Code Rum guy, actually makes a cinnamon rum.
All right.
So we're going to give that one a shot.
All right. Hey, honey, don't expect me to do much tomorrow.
That one's already kind of been eaten on. You can just take a swig out of that, boy.
Or are we just kind of opening it and going boop?
Yeah, man. I don't have any. I mean, we have a bunch of glasses in the game, but
your balls were those. I think I'm gonna drink out of them.
Yeah, exactly. All right, Ringo. So this is to you, my friend. Thanks for leaving these at my house.
Thanks, Ringo.
We're spreading the cinnamon love. All right. Cheers, man.
Cheers. Thanks for having me.
Yeah, of course. Thanks for being here.
It actually tastes like Fireball.
Yep. You know, to me, it tastes like Red Hot's the candy.
Yeah.
To me, it's a little bit less like syrupy than Fireball. It's more like candy water.
It's pretty good.
Yeah, it's good stuff.
I like it. Do you have a problem with your eyes? You can't see anything?
Yeah.
Wait till you get my age. My girlfriend laughs at me all the time. She's always wearing glasses, so me.
Oh, jeez.
I'm still sweating it out. It's pretty funny.
I actually have reading glasses literally all over my entire house.
I refuse.
Yeah.
unless I absolutely have to see what I'm looking at.
Yeah,
I'm
not
putting them on.
I have them here in case I needed to see something real quick. My thing is, man, like I could see far away really, really well. I could read things across a room. Yeah. I can see detail. But anything up close, man, it's over, dude.
Yeah, that's the same here. That's called old age. How old are you?
30. I just turned 35.
Oh, my God. You're a baby.
Thank you. I'll take it.
You know I just turned 45?
No kidding.
Yes.
When's your birthday? I think I knew this, but when?
December 18th.
That's right. I knew we were both Capricorns.
1974.
Look at you. That's all right.
I used to teach math. I graduated in 83.
It's okay. You are exactly the same age as my brother. So there's that.
Is he?
Yeah, 47.
He graduated in 83 also? High school?
No. Oh. I don't know how that works.
That's why I said I'm good at math.
Yeah.
I'm using fuzzy math.
Oh, aha. Okay.
I can get away with that because I can still sing hi.
There you go.
Like, all right. Well, I guess he's right.
going by sting logic, you have 12 more years of high voice singing.
Yeah. He's still doing it.
Yeah, that's true.
The guy's my hero.
Oh man. Well, let's do some more shooting here, and see if we can't get another song or two in before we hit the highway here. How you guys doing out there? Thank you so much for all of you that are sticking around and that have tuned in tonight.
Pretty good. How are you?
You guys are killing the game, and I appreciate you being here for our very first what are you shooting caps? Very first premiere, our official premiere of the show. And you almost made it too. That's impressive. So that counted as a shot, so now it's my turn.
We're not allowed to bring guests in the cabin, so you gotta do something.
Oh, look, D asked me if we had any key lime here, and I'm going to say yes.
In Florida?
We do, D. We have the code key lime here. Now, D is a...
connoisseur of this stuff.
She is, but she also makes rum cakes out of it.
Oh.
And...
Hey, D, you want my address?
you gotta send Terry some rum cakes.
I love rum cake. Oh my god, one of my favorite things to do, pulling into Grand Cayman.
Oh,
I'd visit all the rum place and sample all the rum cakes. It was awesome.
Oh man, yeah, that's their Code Rums. Their rum cakes are out of sight, man. They're really, really good. We'll do a sample of this. We'll shoot and then we'll sample some of that key lime. I need to get you. We need to get you down here to play down in our neck of the woods at some point, man.
Sometime. I've been trying to get in a square grouper, but they don't call me.
Yeah.
No, I send them stuff, and they say, "Ooh, he's too old."
No. They're a tough nut to crack. I just happened to get in there when they were replacing somebody, and I've now been there for 3 years or more now on a regular. But they just like to have their regular people.
Yeah. Yeah. We don't want to bump any regulars out. I don't like
but it happens
that.
All the time, you know. Like people,
if I know them, I don't like that. Man.
People, well, no, not that people
play,
get bumped
I'd
out.
I'd rather play on the street than take out a friend.
Yeah, but sometimes people leave or they get another gig and they do their thing, and that's what happened to me.
Yeah.
Was able to make that work, but yeah, we you know, there's a bunch of places down here, man, that your vibe would go over really well. So I'm gonna have to reach out to my friend Jeff or Zach. They're like, booking agents of a lot of places down here. So we're gonna get. They're gonna see this. They're gonna know how great you are.
Oh.
And we're gonna get you some gigs down here on the Treasure Coast.
Woo-hoo. Have a guitar, we'll travel. Hey, I've traveled quite a ways with this guitar, you know.
Yeah.
How many times around the world your guitar been?
Oh God, at least twice.
I've been three.
Yeah.
Three times around the world. That's
amazing.
And. It's only been under the plane once, and it was a short flight from like Atlanta to Orlando. And they said, we don't have this room, but we'll put it underneath and we'll take care of it. I said, all right, that's my life. Every other flight I've been on, they let me.
Yeah, man.
They put it in the first class coat rack.
Yeah, exactly.
They because they don't know who you are. They think,
sure.
They think you get on the plane with a guitar and they're like, whoa.
Yeah, and the way you carry yourself too, you know. What's funny is I actually bought, and the guitar that I worked with the most on the cruise ships was the Taylor Big Baby.
Mm-hmm.
Now, what's great about that guitar is that the neck is removable.
Oh wow!
So it's two bolts or two screws, and you can, and I've only done it one time, and then, but you can actually take the neck off, and it fits in a backpack, and you can put it under the seat.
Wow.
It's incredible, right? But what's great about that guitar also is that it would fit in the overhead compartment long ways, and people could still put their bags in.
Yeah.
And it doesn't crush the neck. and most people's bags could still fit right in without a problem. So they would never give me shit because the body was the size of a regular carry-on. So and I would explain that to them and show them, and they'd be like, "Oh yeah, no worries."
They've always had sympathy for me. They've always taken care of my guitar. And it's my baby.
Well, I mean, I don't know how sympathy it is. Like, it's kind of their job to do that, for Christ's sake.
I had one bad experience. I was in New Zealand. I was leaving a cruise, and I was down there for like 2 months. I was leaving out of New Zealand, and the lady said, "You can't take that on the plane." I said, "What do you mean I can't take it on the plane? I brought it here."
Yeah. It got here,
she
didn't
goes,
it?
"Well, what airline did you fly?" I said, "I don't know. It was like some airline, but I brought it here." And they say, "Well, our plane, it won't fit on the plane." So she goes, "What I'm going to do, I'm going to give you a little ticket." Said, "Give it to the gate agent, and they'll take your guitar." And I'm thinking, yeah, this isn't going to happen. So I kind of hid the ticket they got, and I put the guitar on my back, and I walked on the plane, and I found a place overhead, put it up there, boom, done.
Yep.
I didn't say anything.
I've done it before where they mentioned something, and the bag that I had was like a backpack bag. So I literally flipped it upside down and put it on upside down. So the neck was kind of like going down my legs, and it just looked like a regular backpack. Mm. And they just didn't even, you know, and then you figure it out when you get on there. You get on there, and then you got to make quick moves. But
the newbies don't know what they're doing. But the seasoned one, you always look for the seasoned attendants there, because they know what's going on.
Yeah, for sure.
Stay away from the newbies.
Yeah, and I've even been like, "Listen, man, I work on a cruise ship. I fly all the time." And they're like, "Oh, okay, then you know the drill." You know, I don't know. You want to shoot?
Yep.
Whose turn is it? I have a ball loaded up.
All right, bring it on.
My turn.
And we'll try a little key lime, and then I'm gonna have to drink some water.
Hey, now Brad knows what it's like to be in my neck of the woods.
Oh!
Hey, Jordan, guess who's not getting lucky tonight?
Oh, man. All right, let's pull my wheel up here.
Pull your what?
My Wii.
Oh.
My Wii.
I love the Wii. Oh, the wheel.
Of doom. Oh, I think I jumped. Mrs. Robinson. You can get some harmonies on this, right?
Yeah, I can do that.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Oh, gosh.
I can help you out here.
God, I do this song so often.
Is this one of your hate songs?
It is, believe it or not. I mean, I don't hate it, but I, you know, I play it a lot.
Wait a minute, Jordan Taylor. Terry's got it now. He's kicking your butt in this game. Oh, that game.
This game. He finally figured it out.
I'm pretty good with my fingers. But that's, you know, when you see me, that's all I do all day long. That's
right.
She goes, "What the hell are you doing?" I say, "I'm just fidgeting."
Yeah, fidgeting.
Itching. I like to itch my knees.
These fingers, you know. Oh yeah, I forgot I muted it. What song is that?
That was Spirit of Radio by Rush.
You're right. It is Spirit of the Radio. All right.
I literally played that song last Friday at Costa. The Canadians in the crowd were impressed.
I have a tuner. I don't know why I don't use it.
They come in handy.
Right.
Do you have one on your phone?
I do.
This new technology is amazing. I said I'd be dangerous if I had this technology when I was 19, 20. Oh my God. But now it's like it advances from you. Because you get kind of tired of watching it.
Right. Yeah, man. I don't know, man. I would be a tremendously better guitar player if I had YouTube back in the day.
I'm constantly learning how to play songs on YouTube. It's amazing.
It's great, right?
Hey, do you play that new country song by Old Dominion?
One man band. No, I've had 1,000 requests for it. Hey, I need to learn it.
Watch this.
Yeah?
Watch this. I'm telling you, you're going to want to learn this.
All right.
It's a freaking awesome song. It's
so good.
I just forget the words. No, seriously. I don't want to be no one. Nobody's singing a harmony. Up there, just me and my shadow. No bass, no guitar, no tambourine. And I found you like a melody. You were singing in the same key as me. We had them dancing in the street. I don't wanna be a one-man band. I don't wanna be a rolling stone alone. Putting miles on a rundown van. Maybe we could take our own show on the road. We'll lay down the beat and carry the tune. We'll get tattoos and we'll crash hotel rooms. Maybe take my hand. I don't want to be a one-man band. See, this is like my song. It's like, dude, they were calling my name.
Seriously,
when
it's such a good one. I do need to learn it. I do need to learn it. For sure. Like, it's right up the alley, man.
It's a great musician song. It's a pretty song. It's a country song, and I'm starting to like country thanks to Marcia. She introduced me to country.
I remember a couple of years ago, you were like, I know one country song. It was a Zac Brown song.
Well, yeah.
It was like Toes in the Sand or something.
Well, you know, and another thing that changed it, one of my favorite parts of the world is like the South Pacific. So I'm cruising around there, and these people are coming up and saying, hey, can you play some... what's the Australian guy?
Keith Urban.
Can play some Keith Urban. I said, I don't know Keith Urban. But I come back home, meet Marcia. Oh, that's Keith Urban. So,
right.
I was like, I'm sorry, I learned some Keith Urban stuff.
Keith Urban, man, he's gnarly, man. He's a great guitar player too.
He's a good musician. He's great.
He had that one song. One of the songs I play from him is that, like. We jump right past that no trespassing sign. Sat on the tailgate and watched the planes take off. Thought we had all night, there was no need to rush. That's when those cops came pulling up. And I thought, man, ain't this some shit. Sweet daddy's gonna kill me. But if I survive tonight, I wouldn't change one thing. Baby, I know it sounds crazy. There was something about the way the blue lights were shining, bringing out the freedom in your eyes. I was too busy watching you go wild, child. But am I going to jail? I'm thinking about running for it, make a good story. I was thinking you were crazy as hell. But you were so innocent, but you were stealing my heart. Fell in love in the back of a cop car. Fell in love in the back of a cop car. Can't get much more country than that, really.
I used to wash cop cars. My dad was a cop in Canada.
Ah,
he ran home and said, hey, you want to make $5? The city's going to pay you $5 to wash this car. I was like, I was like 9. Sounds good deal to me.
Yeah, so that was around like 1992. Yeah, if we're doing the math,
no,
we're doing Terry math.
We're going way back. No, we're talking like the 70s, early 70s.
Oh, I was talking to somebody, man, about like the 1980s, and they were talking about like some oceanfront property was renting out, like a oceanfront condo was renting out for like, I don't know, like $300 or something, like $350 a month. I was like, oh, let's go back to those days. Crazy. Yeah. Oh, man. Well, my brother, I think we're winding down here.
All right.
We want to do
thanks for having me.
Oh, my God.
This was fun.
Thank you. Thanks for coming.
Where else can you go and just have fun talking on a microphone, play guitar, and drink beer every night of the week.
Every night of the week. But yeah, man, I appreciate you being here, man. Thank you so much. I'm going to put the balloons up again for our official launch of the Jams and Cocktails show here. Thank you for being my first official guest. All my guests before this, I love you guys. We're going to have you back with a new show, and it's going to be awesome. But Terry, you've done me an honor by being my guest here, and I love you, man. I appreciate you being here. And we'll have you back. I'm going to get you back with Josh and the boys, and we'll have a little powwow. It'll be the Dobson Brock show.
Right. Sounds awesome. He'd like that. Yeah. I'd like that. Yep. Thanks for having us. Thanks for having me.
Yeah, man, of course.
This is fun. This is awesome. I'm looking around. I'm thinking, this is pretty cool.
Right? It's cozy.
Yeah. I like it a lot. And I really like your tequila. The Juan tequila. That's pretty good stuff.
Number one, it is really good.
That's good stuff.
Now I'm gonna have to go and get another bottle of it.
Next time I come, I'll bring a bottle. Do you like scotch?
I love scotch.
I'll bring a bottle of Lagavulin scotch. It's my favorite scotch.
Yeah. I'm a Glenlivet guy.
Yeah, this is better than
it's better?
Oh my god, is it better?
No kidding.
Oh, absolutely. Hands down.
All right. I'm in. I love it.
All right, you just come over and visit us one day when you're in Vero. Just call me and say, hey, I'm in Vero. So come on over and I got some Lagavulin.
I think I'm up at Walking Tree at the end of the month.
Right.
On a Friday night.
Is that Amanda? Amanda, who books up there?
Ron Hart from Earth Tones Productions is booking for them.
Oh, is that a booking agent?
Mm-hmm. Right. Mm-hmm. He's actually down here. But yeah, he booked me. He books me in there. But Amanda was originally the one that got me in. She saw me at the farmer's market up there and got me in. I love it up there. They're great people.
I love their IPA. They have great IPA. Every bar I go to, I get a Sailfish IPA.
Yeah. Nice. You want to sing Mrs. Robinson with me, and we'll call it an evening?
Sure.
All right, here we go. I do it in E.
Is that the original key?
Absolutely not.
You're older than I. Are you sure you're not older than me?
I don't know. I told you. I don't know how old I am anymore.
Age is just a number. It's like what you can do.
And here's to you, Mrs. Robinson. Jesus loves you more than you will know. Whoa, whoa, whoa. God bless you, please, Mrs. Robinson. Heaven knows a place for those who pray. Hey, hey, hey. Hey, hey. We'd like to know a little bit about you for our thoughts. We'd like to help you learn to help yourself. Look around you, all you see are sympathetic eyes. Stroll around the grounds until you feel at home. And here's to you, Mrs. Robinson. Jesus loves you more than you will know. Whoa, whoa, whoa. God bless you, please, Mrs. Robinson. Heaven knows a place for those who pray. Hey, hey, hey. Hey, hey, hey. Sitting on a hiding place where no one ever goes. Your pantry with your cupcakes. It's a little secret, just the Robinsons are there. most of all, you got to hide it from the kids. Coo-coo-coo-choo, Mrs. Robinson, Jesus loves you more than you will know. Whoa, whoa, whoa. God bless you, please, Mrs. Robinson. Heaven knows a place for those who pray. Hey, hey, hey. Hey, hey. Sitting on a sofa on a Sunday afternoon, going to the candidates debate. Laugh about it, shout about it when you've got to choose. Any way you look at it, you lose. Where have you gone, Joe DiMaggio? A nation turns its lonely eyes to you. Woo, woo, woo. What's that you say, Mrs. Robinson? Tolton Joe has left and gone away. Hey, hey, hey. Hey, hey.
Right on, right on. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for tuning in. Give it up once again for my man, Terry, Jerry.
Yoo-hoo! That was wild. Thanks, Brad. It was fun.
Yes, sir. Yes,
thanks,
sir.
Thanks for the cocktails. I like that.
Oh, man.
Jams and cocktails. Yeah, that's
jams
that's,
and cocktails.
I like it a lot. I like it a lot.
Thank you so much for being here, Terry. I appreciate you, man. We'll see you next time. Next time, we'll get you with Josh.
Bye, guys. Thanks for coming out.
You guys, be sure to like the stream. Send us a... let me get my cue cards here. I tossed one away. be sure to go and join the Jams and Cocktails live stream show page on Facebook. The link is in the description in the post here for the live stream. So you go click that and join the group. I will accept you, of course, and you'll get the first updates on all the stuff going on. If you really had a good time and you want to go the extra mile, you can throw us a little bit of jingle. That link is also in the description. I appreciate you. Next week, we have Andrew Scott, another singer-songwriter here on the Treasure Coast, a good friend of mine, and a great, great entertainer. So put it on your calendars to tune in next Wednesday at 8 p.m., for another edition of Jams and Cocktails. Thank you so much, you guys, and good night.